Welcome to another Fluidit tutorial lesson. This time, we'll talk about how to add, select, and edit model components. Let's first have a look at manually adding new components. There will be a separate session on how to import components. Here we will just have a look how to manually add new components. Junctions can be automatically created with pipes, so let's just have a look how to add pipes. You can select the material used from this drop-down menu, or use the shortcut space. Pipe tool is automatically activated. Then just start drawing pipes. Mouse click creates a vertex, that is a bend in the pipe, but does not end the pipe component. Vertices being drawn can be undoed with backspace, or use ESC to cancel completely at any time. The pipe is ended and a junction created by holding Control down while making the click, like this. Same can also be used to split an existing pipe, either in the end or at the start. You can modify an existing pipe by dragging its vertices. First select the pipe and then just move the vertex. New vertices can be added via a right click. Area components, such as catchments and dem modification areas, are drawn basically the same way, but a double click ends the drawing and creates the component. Next, a few words about managing demands, or inflows as they are called in sewer and storm. Demands can be assigned directly to junctions here, but usually they are modeled as so-called geocoded demands. They are separate point components that exist outside the actual hydraulic network and are then connected to a junction in the network, their so-called parent. For the hydraulic calculations, their actual location does not matter, but only the junction they are connected to. Under Tools, there is a general tool for connecting demands to their nearest junctions. Junctions can be marked with a Ignore for geocoded. Then no demand is connected here. Demand parents can also be adjusted manually by first selecting the demands and then right-clicking on the junction you wish to connect to. Answer yes to making them stick to their manually adjusted parent. That is, they no longer update when running the general tool. All model components, whether physical or non-physical, can be found as tables under Model menu. These tables can be sorted according to any property or result by clicking on the title. This is one way to find components with extreme values. For example, highest junctions or pipes with highest velocity. Simple columns can be customized via a right click anywhere on the table and select visible columns. Components selected in the table can also be selected in the map view by taking a right click and using Select in Map View. This works also the other way around. First, select some components in the map view and use Select from Map View. There is also an option to show only selected that is, filter all the other components out of the table. There is also a table functionality directly in the map view. If you have any component selected in the map view, via a right click, you can open them as a table. Let's next talk about other methods for selecting components. Basic selecting is easy, with mouse click or lasso. You can combine this with Control to add to selection, or Control and Shift to remove from selection. Via map view of right click, you also have access to several selection tools. For example, select network segment and select components upstream or downstream. Search tool can be accessed with Control F, as with most software. This tool is a great example on the Fluidit product philosophy. It is very simple to use for simple things, but offer almost unlimited possibilities for advanced users. Most simple way to search is by component name. Just type the name and click OK. You can also search for tags just by typing the tag name. Then it selects all the components with the searched tag. Next step is to search with property values. For this, we need to know the property's machine name, that is, how it is called programmatically. Luckily, that is easily available like this. In Properties window, right-click on the property and select Copy Property Name. Let's copy pipe diameter as an example. Now, paste the property name and add the search criteria. In our example, diameter larger than 100. When using simulated results as search criteria, you need to add the phrase result, like this. Results programmatical names can be accessed the same way as properties. All these have just scratched the surface of this tool. You can also use JavaScript to write any search functions you need. For examples, see our wiki page, Component Search and Filters. After getting the components we want selected, it is time to learn how to mass edit them. In its most simple form, user can simply input the wanted value into the properties field like this. More advanced editing can be done with Field Calculator. You can open this tool with a right click on the property you want to edit. You are automatically offered the corresponding parameter's name as a starting point. Now you can add any calculation to this, for example, multiply or subtract. In this example, I'll multiply the current water consumption values by 1.5. Field Calculator can also refer to other parameters or results than the one being modified, and also be used for various other more complex calculations. Please refer to Wiki again for more info on these. Most other tools are also available to use as mass edit, for selected components, including many map view tools. For example, if you have several junctions selected, you can join them all at once. This lesson had a lot of different tools. By combining these, you can easily manage and modify even large numbers of components. Remember also to check our wiki for more advanced searches and field calculator expressions.